Hello everyone, it's Spookay here, and today we are making a full review on the drip client. So I have it right here. That's GUI. It looks pretty good. It's using GUI, pretty sure. So we're gonna turn on chroma because I don't know, some people like to see that in my videos, but okay. So let's disable friends because we don't have any friends right now to play with us. So I'm gonna try to explain everything to the best that I can because I'm not really good at explaining, but hopefully I don't mess up and make a fool out of myself. So these are the modules that I'm gonna use right here. I'm gonna try to like explain everything here. So for this, I'll probably go like something like this. Yeah, because you guys know Arcane is a pretty bad Minecraft server, so their anti-cheat is, well, not really the best, so I can go pretty blatant with this. Velocity, maybe somewhere like this. Yeah, that works. Let's see, aim assist, we're gonna turn this up to 4. I like to use 80, so I do not recommend you guys to use this setting because it's very blatant here. So let's turn this on. Let's see, what else? Misplace, reach. They actually have a reach module here, which I will actually use maybe later, I don't know. So you have your usual ESP here, so I'll turn that on as well to show you guys. And we're gonna use W tap, and we're gonna set the delay. We're gonna use like 500 to like somewhere like there. Yeah, that should be good. And timer, we're not going to use that because it's blatant and it's easily detected. I think it's pretty self-explanatory what tracer is, and we're going to use throw pot here. So let's bind this. You can bind by shift clicking it and G. Refill, it's refilling your pots, but we can do that ourselves. All right, I'll see you guys when we get into a match. Oh wait, actually let me actually clip this to the left. Oh, oops, let's try to make this perfect. There we go, now that looks good. Alright, I'll see you guys there. Alright, we are in a match now, so let's just get our pots. Oh, and I don't know if I've mentioned this earlier, but yeah, make sure to check out Fast Ults. I'll put their links in the description. Okay, I'm already getting kind of outreached by this guy right here. I mean, to be honest, everyone's cheating nowadays. And there's something I'd like to point out about the throw pot. It's kind of minor, but it will throw out your pots regardless of your whole health, like your health bar. Like, it still throws. That's kind of like Demon's throw pot. Unlike throw pot and Vape, where it only throw potions when you have 4 hearts missing, because it's universal that a pot can only like heal you like 3 to 4 health, depending on the position that you throw the pot in the direction, you know? So that's just a minor little detail that I just want to point out. And wow, our misplace is very noticeable because we just beat that guy. So the auto clicker also works with my keystrokes. That's pretty good because I've used Vape before and it doesn't work, so that's kind of sucks. I don't know how the auto clicker really works. So let's kill this guy. And I can't really notice the W tap, probably because I set the delay to like really high. So yeah. Oh, that's a pretty good combo right there. So I'm also gonna talk about some other stuff in this video. So if you guys didn't know, MindQ, the server is getting shut down. So I'll put a link in the description if you wanna check that out. It's kind of shocking, to be honest, like thinking of all the time and money that was invested into the project and then all of it gone down because of the drama. So you know, that's that. So if you guys want to check it out, I'll put it in the description. That was a close fight right there, guys. Oh, I forgot to show you guys this, but I actually changed my mind and I decided to use refill just so I can show you guys like everything in the client. So I bind it to my B, so every time I press B it will kind of refill all my potions for me. I'll show that again once I run out of potions here. So it kind of like have a small delay where it keeps you in the inventory after the pots, so that should be an easy fix. I mean, it depends on where your delay is for the refill. I'm not using the default one. I kind of like turned it down just to speed up the process and the procedures. And also, I feel like the aim assist is doesn't have any randomization, because I feel like I'm just hitting my cursor just kind of, oh, oops, let's use refill. So my cursor is just like pulling into the center of the entity, which is kind of weird and seems kind of blatant to me. And I have the speed at 3, guys. I changed it from 4 to 3 because, you know, I kind of want to test out how it is when you put it to low. So other than that, I would say it's pretty good. And also this client or ghost client, I don't know, I think it's a I call it a ghost client. Well, it is a ghost client. It's kind of like a alternative if you guys don't want to buy something much more premium and expensive like Vape Lite. I mean, Vape V3 isn't really a ghost client. It's kind of like in a category of its own, because, you know, it's like half blatant and half, you know, ghost. All right, let's win this fight. I don't want to lose to this normie right here. Well, let's speed up. Oops. Oh my god, this guy is good. Is he cheating as well? I'm literally using like 3.9 reach. Oh, that was close. So yeah, if you guys want to pick up Drip, you can do so in the description. It is a public client, unlike a Iridium Ghost that's like slotted, but it's public. It goes for like around 25 euros, so pretty cheap for a ghost client. And this pack is kind of getting old, to be honest. I might try to like find a new pack, because it kind of feels boring to use the same pack over and over in videos. So we're gonna play like one more fight here, so let's try to play something unique. Oh yes, combo, let's go. Yo, let's play combo. Let's see how well this client can do. So this client's text UI really reminds me of a Iridium Ghost. If you guys haven't seen my previous video, you can check it out. It was like a montage or something, like a mini montage that I kind of made. The text UI looks really similar. And this guy's rocking me, hello? Oh no, this guy's destroying me. Jeez. Okay, calm down. I don't understand what that was, but okay. Let's try not to lose here and look like a loser in front of a video. So now we're trading hits, okay. Come on, die. There we go, now he's taking the L and getting tossed. Maybe not. There we go, GG, easy. He said WTF in the chat. Okay, let's play one more match here, because I don't know how long I've been recording, but hopefully it was for a decent amount of time. So I can't really tell the WTAP. That's most likely because, you know, have the delay really high, because I know that some WTAPs get you banned. Because if you guys don't know, I believe Gorilla, the WTAP was like server side or something. It's kind of like weird. I don't know, like some WTAP, they calculate the range that you are like against your opponent in the WTAP at that moment in delay. So I don't understand how that works. That's why I put the delay up really high. And that fight was really short because I quick dropped that guy. So last one. I'm gonna stop procrastinating, all right? Okay, let's kill. Let's try to have a good fight right here. So this guy seems okay. Oh, this guy's lagging. That's not good. Oh yeah, he's lagging for sure. Rip. Alright. And my pearl isn't working as well.
Oh my god, this guy's lagging so hard. He must be from EU or something. Okay, we almost died right there though. You see, laggers always get the high-end advantage regardless if you're cheating or not. Because sometimes in their screen, you're just like frozen in place and they just crit you out. Like, that's kind of stupid. Arcane, oh, should have like an EU proxy for these people. Alright, we won. GG.
So, thank you guys for watching. As I said, if you want a trip, you can do so. Check out the description. All the links that are important and will be there. And I'll see you guys in the next video.